Hello, this is Reggie with the Fortify On Demand team. Today I'm going to be going over installing the Fortify On Demand plugin for Visual Studio. And then I'll also demonstrate the Fortify Security Assistant plugin. So the Fortify On Demand plugin allows you to upload payloads to Fortify On Demand for scans, as well as download the results from those scans. The Security Assistant plugin allows you to get live as you code vulnerability information on a subset of vulnerabilities. It won't show you everything that a scan does, but it will show you a subset of those vulnerabilities right as you code. So what we're going to start with is installing the plugins. So in Visual Studio, this is really easy. Here you would click on Tools, Extension and Updates, go to Online, and we're going to search for Fortify. So you'll see that there are two. There is Fortify On Demand Extension for Visual Studio and Fortify Security Assistant for Visual Studio. One note, Fortify Security Assistant for Visual Studio does require Visual Studio 2017. So if you're on an older version of Visual Studio, you wouldn't see this download available and you won't be able to install it. But this one will be available in earlier versions of Visual Studio. And if you're on 2017, you can also download Security Assistant, which again gives you live vulnerability information as you're coding. So I'm going to select download for my FOD extension, and it should be pretty quick. And then I'm going to click download on Security Assistant. Once both finish downloading, you'll see that they're scheduled for install. So you have to actually close Visual Studio for them to install. So I'm going to do that now. When you close it, you should see this VSIX installer running. So you have to allow this process to finish, and that will install the plugins. After it finishes initializing, you will have to agree to some license agreements. Clicking Modify agrees to them. Once Visual Studio opens back up, you'll notice that you have two new menu items, Fortify Security Assistant and Fortify. We're going to concentrate first on Fortify. So you'll notice if you first click on it that upload projects to Fortify on demand is grayed out unless you have a project open. So you do have to have a project open in your Solution Explorer to be able to upload it, because that's what it's looking for to upload. So it's just any solution file that once you open it up and fine. Once it finishes opening, you will be able to upload your project to Fortify On Demand. The first time that you open Security Assistant, you're going to get this message. For now, I'm going to close it and I'll show you that process later. It's attempting to scan as I open the file. So essentially, the reason it asks for the license file right after you've installed that plugin is it's immediately going to try to do sort of live coverage of your application, but I'm not quite ready to show that yet. So I just close that message. That's perfectly fine. It's not going to cause any errors. And then click Fortify, upload projects to Fortify on demand. At this point, you will have the option to send your project, solution references, and binaries. I'm going to send everything. So I'm going to choose upload package to Fortify on demand. Click next. So I want to show you how you can get this URL if you don't know what it is. So to do that, what you would want to do is log into the Fortify on demand portal. Click your name in the upper right, and then click API Explorer. That's going to take you to api.ams.fortify.com. Now, it's /swagger/UI/index, but you don't need to go to the Swagger docs. All you need to provide is the API URL, so it's just that root URL there. And that's what I would enter in here. Click Next. Make sure you type in your password correctly. And it should load your projects from Fortify On Demand. Now, it will essentially download a list of releases. You may have more or less or fewer releases, just depending upon how many releases you have access to in the Fortify On Demand portal. I'm going to use the IDE demo release. We're going to do a static basic subscription.net. I'm going to set my language level to 4.7. You do have some advanced options here where you can set things like including third-party libraries. I don't want to do that. You would also have this option. I don't have it because it's not turned on for my test tenant, but it is turned on. If it is turned on for you, you'll have an option to select open source component analysis. That's a sonatype report, and it's separate from your static analysis. Once you click Next, it's going to add all of your files to a zip. It's going to package it up, zip it, and upload it to Fortify On Demand. Once you've uploaded and run an assessment through that process or through a build server integration or manually through the portal, you can start downloading the results from those scans with the same plugin. So if I click Fortify, you'll notice there's another option, Open Analysis Results. Click on that. It will ask you to log in again if you haven't already done that. Since I just logged in to perform the upload, I don't have to do it again. I'm going to select my IDE release demo and click Finish. And it's going to download my vulnerabilities right into my IDE. So what you'll see here, expand this a bit. If I select a vulnerability, this is a cross-site scripting reflected vulnerability in a C# file. It's going to open the file. Now, I don't have the proper linking set up because I did not upload this project. If I had the solution file set up, it would actually open this right in my own solution. In this case, it had to download the file. This is not the project that I just uploaded. You should actually have it opening your file if you have the same solution on your machine that was uploaded. Otherwise, it will do this where it downloads a copy of the file. Now, there is a code trace here. So, for example, this is in a C# file, but there's also a web config file in the trace. If I select that, it will download the web config file. So I can run through this entire trace just like I would be able to do in the portal. Down below, I have my details. This is the vulnerabilities tab in the portal where it gives you a description and an explanation of the definition of the vulnerability. I also have a recommendations tab. This gives me the recommended solution, how to implement that in my code. My audit summary has a history of comments out of the portal. It allows me to assign this vulnerability to a user, which is what I'm doing now. And I'll show you the significance of that, but you can also set your developer status. If you're an auditor in the portal, you can change your auditor status. When you make changes there, it will have to communicate with the portal, so it might take a moment. I can also change my severity as an auditor. So whatever options you have in the portal on that right-hand side of the screen will be available here as well. If you're a developer, you'll just have the developer status dropdown. There's nothing missing. That's okay. You won't necessarily have all of these options. There's also the history tab. So you can actually see the history under comments on the comment tab. But there will be additional history items potentially if it's been found in multiple releases and that sort of thing, they will appear on the history tab. You'll notice over here that you get your analysis trace. So that's up here as well in your list of vulnerabilities, but it's also, you can leave it collapsed here and still get your issue trace on the right-hand side in Visual Studio. Now, remember that I assigned this vulnerability to a user. If I am a team lead, I can assign vulnerabilities in Visual Studio, and then my users can set assigned user as their sorting method and see if I'm Brown Reginald, I can expand that and see that this vulnerability was assigned to me to fix. So I can sort it and see the specific vulnerabilities assigned to myself. So that's how to consume results out of the portal. There is one step remaining for me to demonstrate today, and that's Fortify Security Assistant. So I'm going to close my downloaded files here because I also have a solution open. I'm going to go back to my Solution Explorer, and I am going to select Fortify Security Assistant, Analyze Solution. Now, I haven't run this before, so it's asking me for a Fortify Security Assistant license. To get that, we're going to want to return to the portal, click my name, tools, and on this page, you'll see that there are a few downloads for license files. So it should be available for you. If I hover over, you'll see that this is my download license file for the source code analyzer. You'll see if I hover over Security Assistant for Eclipse, it's there. Or Fortify Security Assistant for Visual Studio. This is the same license file, but I'm going to click this download link, and it will download a file called fortify.license. Once I've downloaded it, I'm going to click Browse. I'm going to go to my desktop, which is where I put it, and I'm going to select Fortify License. Click OK. I'm going to check for updates. You don't have to do that necessarily, but I'm going to do that. Click OK. Now, if you don't see that your security content has a date on it, you will need to check for updates, but those will keep themselves up to date. But if it's your first time and it hasn't yet done that, like was the case for me, you can manually trigger the check for updates with that button there. Click OK. And now it's going to analyze my solution. Now, once it's finished analyzing the solution for the first time, it should give you results as you move along. But there will be a process that takes a few moments to finish the first time that you run it. Once Security Assistant finishes its scan, it will indicate that it's completed it. We can close that. And your vulnerabilities will actually appear in as an error. So in my case here, I'm not currently viewing errors, so you just go to View Error List, and then they would actually be warnings that appear in your error list. So let's see, these won't all be Fortify issues, but these are. So anywhere that you see these Fs, so you'll see them in yellow as a low, orange as a high, and red as a critical. You'll see these icons. So we'll go to that line, and you'll see that this is where it is flagging an issue. So you can view vulnerability details by right-clicking there. And that'll give you an abstract, an explanation, and a recommendation as to how to fix it. So that's how you view vulnerability information with Security Assistant. Now, as a reminder, Fortify Security Assistant will only provide a subset of vulnerabilities, concentrating on OWASP top 10 vulnerabilities. It can't do the analysis traces that happen in your full scans of the code. But it will give you some vulnerabilities so that when you get your results back, they're a little bit easier to parse through because you've shifted some of this fixing sort of left in your cycle so that when you're coding your your code, you can fix these issues right away, so you don't have to get a scan back and fix them then. It will definitely help you in that regard. Thank you, and have a great day.